when I press password on the keypad, the lock will unlock. If I want to lock it again, I can simply enter the same password. The door will lock. Now, let me explain the push button. This is for convenience. For example, if you unlock the door, enter your room, and want to lock or unlock it quickly from the inside, you can use this button instead of the keypad. First, I'll enter 1234 hash on the keypad and see, the door is unlocked. Now, I'll press the same 1234 hash again and it's locked. Finally, I'll show you how the push button works. When I press the button, it quickly locks or unlocks the door for ease of use. A few days ago, I made a project similar to today's project. In that project, I used both a keypad and an RFID. If you want to watch that video, I'll provide the link in the video description. You can check it out there. So, let's start today's video. First of all, you'll need a small piece of PVC sheet. Take the lock mechanism and fix it securely onto the PVC sheet using a glue gun. I have a request for you. If you haven't subscribed to the channel yet, kindly subscribe and don't forget to like the video. It really motivates me to create more amazing content like this. Also, if you have any questions related to this video, feel free to ask in the comment section. I'll do my best to help you as much as I can. After this, we'll take a servo motor and fix it onto the PVC sheet as well. Next, we'll take a servo motor along with a steel wire like this. One end of the wire will be attached to the hole in the servo motor and the other end will be glued to the lock mechanism using glue. This setup will ensure that when the servo motor moves, the lock mechanism will also move back and forth accordingly. Now we'll need an Arduino Uno, 4x4 keypad, display module, a push button, breadboard, and some jumper wires. First, we'll connect the 4x4 keypad to the Arduino. Next, we will connect the display module to the Arduino. The display module has 4 pins, GND. Connect this to the ground rail of the breadboard. VCC. Connect this to the positive rail of the breadboard. SDA. Connect this to the A4 pin on the Arduino SCL. Connect this to the A5 pin on the Arduino. Place the push button on the breadboard. Connect one wire GND rail on the breadboard. Connect second wire to A0 pin on the Arduino. Take two jumper wires. First wire, connect the GND pin on the Arduino to the GND rail negative line on the breadboard. Second wire, connect the 5V pin on the Arduino to the positive rail on the breadboard. Now our circuit diagram is complete. The final step is to connect the servo motor to the Arduino. Servo motor has three wires. Red wire, connect to the positive rail 5V line on the breadboard. Brown wire, connect to the GND rail on the breadboard. Yellow wire, connect to pin 12 on the Arduino. Open the Arduino IDE, load the provided code file, scroll to the top of the code, and you will see some libraries mentioned. Install required libraries. Copy the library name mentioned in the code example, servo.h. In the Arduino IDE, go to Sketch. Include library, manage libraries. A search bar will appear. Paste the library name into the search bar. Click Install if the library is not already installed. If you see update instead of install, it means the library is already installed. Scroll down the code to locate the password variable. If you want to change the password, you can do it by select board and port. In the Arduino IDE, go to Tools or Board and select the correct Arduino model, go to Tools Support and select the port where your Arduino is connected. Upload the code, click the upload button, wait for the message done uploading to appear in the console below. Now, let's watch the demo of this project. But before we start, I have a small request. Like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel. Thank you. Power the Arduino. Connect the Arduino to a power source using a USB cable or a 5V adapter. Once powered, the system will initialize. Unlocking the lock. Enter the password 1234 Maya's on the keypad. The display will show a message like unlocked, and the servo motor will move, unlocking the door. Locking the door. To lock the door again, enter the same password 134 VAS. The display will show locked and the servo motor will return to its original position, locking the door. Using the push button. If you press the push button, the door will toggle between lock and unlock modes without needing the keypad. One press will unlock the door, another press will lock it again.